Hey, welcome back everyone. It is now March 26th of 2020, and ever since the release of Star Wars The Rise of Skywalker, a lot of fans have been very curious about the future of the Star Wars franchise by Disney and Lucasfilm, and exactly how the new Disney CEO, Bob Chapek, is going to handle everything moving forward for this Star Wars brand. This is Mike Zero. Make sure to subscribe if you're new to the channel for future Star Wars content. Now, one thing is for certain is that Disney and Lucasfilm are primarily focused on Disney Plus and their live-action TV series to come that's really going to play a major role in this new Star Wars universe that's also going to tie directly into the movies, the comics, the books, and etc. You know, we know that this is a big plan by Disney CEO Bob Chapek in order to really kind of model it after the MCU and make it just as successful as the MCU was and still is, I must add. You know, when we think about Disney Star Wars, a lot of fans have issues with The Last Jedi and The Rise of Skywalker, and that's perfectly fine. Everybody has their own opinion. But now, moving forward, thankfully, Kathleen Kennedy no longer has creative control over the new Star Wars projects in the early development phase, and of course, everything related to the new books, novels, and comics, you name it. So, the one aspect of the new Star Wars universe that is quite exciting is the return of Darth Vader, and exactly how this is all going to be implemented on Disney Plus in the form of a Darth Vader-centered TV series that is in the early development phase as we speak. Now, with that being said, what's really intriguing, of course, is that now that both Disney and Lucasfilm are finished with the Skywalker saga, they are focused on their new Star Wars trilogy of films, as well as their new Star Wars universe. Currently, the new Disney CEO, Bob Chapek, is making major changes over at Lucasfilm in order to create a brighter future for the Star Wars brand and for the Star Wars community. Now, it's noted that currently Lucasfilm is working on many projects in the early development phase that will bring fans to new eras of the franchise, as well as a new mythology in general. It's noted that currently Disney is developing a Darth Vader-centered TV series that is in the early development phase that would include a more personal side to Darth Vader. It's explained that the show is really a Jedi Purge TV series with Darth Vader as the main villain, and that one of the big plans by Lucasfilm is to include a side story of Darth Vader's path and/or journey to resurrecting Padme Amidala to model it after what was told in the comics, and the story of his thirst for power to create life that Palpatine once revealed to him in Episode 3. Not just that, but also Lucasfilm plans to tie the Darth Vader TV series with the Mace Windu TV series, where it's explained that this plan by Lucasfilm is to give the fans a different side of Vader and to have him part of the new Star Wars universe and to also have interactions between a suited Vader and the return of Mace Windu. It's also explained that Lucasfilm plans to bring back Emperor Palpatine in some way, shape, or form for this new series to make it feel like a true sequel to Episode 3, Revenge of the Sith. So, what's really exciting about this is that they want to show a different side of Vader in this TV series that is essentially going to be a Jedi Purge TV show with Darth Vader as the main villain. Now, what's really exciting about this is that this is, of course, going to tap into his path to resurrecting Padme Amidala. In case you guys did not know, in the comics, this is a very big story, and it's actually still going as we speak, of Darth Vader's journey to finding a secret power or a specific way to bring Padme back from the dead. And that is going to be an ongoing story in the comics, not just in the comics, but also in this live-action TV series for Disney+. The thing that's really exciting about this also is how they want to tie this directly into the planned Mace Windu TV series, where both Mace and Vader will cross paths. This could very well be the explanation as to why Mace Windu is a Force ghost during the events of The Rise of Skywalker, when you hear his voice talking to Rey, telling her, feel the Force flowing through you, Rey. Now, the thing about all of this, right? When you think about Disney Star Wars, they really are trying to expand on many of the familiar characters that they really want to use as selling points, right? A lot of fans love the Skywalkers, they love Kenobi, they love Darth Vader, and that's exactly what they're going to provide on Disney+, let alone Ahsoka Tano getting her own TV series. I don't know if you guys heard this. On top of that, she's also going to cameo in The Mandalorian Season 2. Looking forward to that as well. So, the last thing I just want to really actually go over here is how they are going to tap into new Star Wars lore, basically uncovering this power that would bring Padme back from the dead, and or at least an attempt by Darth Vader to bring her back from the dead in this new TV series that is going to be based on the Star Wars comics that are currently canon. So, like I've said before, you know, Mustafar got a brief appearance in The Rise of Skywalker. There is no reason to doubt that Mustafar will not return in this planned TV show that will also focus on Darth Vader as a character, and to show him, or to show us, I should say, a more personal side of his character on Disney+. So, with that being said, guys, you know, let me know what you think about this all below in the comments, and if you guys did enjoy the content for today, do make sure to drop a thumbs up on this video to support the channel. I thank you all so very much for the kind support, and I'll catch you guys next time.